Lisa here for Canvas Core Brand. Today I'm going to be doing a quick and easy project, and I'm going to be using the Naturally Aged Paint System Fine Wood, and I'm going to work through the instructions with you step by step. I've got this lovely piece of butterfly card, and it's part of the mixed media range, the Origins collection, and I'm going to be cutting out these butterflies, but I'm also going to be cutting out this butterfly as well to add to the frame which I'm going to use. It's just a little small frame, and it measures, let's see, it measures just over 4 inches by 4 inches, and it has got glass, so that's going to go inside, and I'm going to decorate it. And I've got a Tim Holtz word that it just says explore. And what else am I going to be using? Oh yes, I'm going to colour the butterflies in the image with Glimmer Mist from Tattered Angels, and this is Sun-Kissed Peach, and I've got Dragonfly. I thought they would be apt colours. So first thing I want to do, because this is glass, I want to use some sticky tape just to cover the glass so it doesn't get marked. It's low tack adhesive, and I'm just going to cover that first. I just don't want any of the paint and sprays to get on the glass. It is a bit fiddly, but if you're patient, it's well worth it in the end than trying to scrape it off your glass. I'm going to just quickly go around all four sides. Just move it straight up, because we're going to be painting this. And then the last side, and then I can get on and make a start. Okay, so I'll cut this out. Sorry about that, I'll just turn that down. There we go. So first thing I want to do is I want to colour this in. So as with all my sprays, I always store them on the side, so the mica always sits on the bottom, on the side, and it just saves the nozzle from clogging. So I'm just going to spritz some on here. I'm using a paintbrush. Pick up a paintbrush and just paint around the butterfly. The paintbrush I'm using is number 6 from I got it just from one of the craft shops here in the UK. I'm letting it pool as well, so it's darker in some places and lighter in others. Just gives it a different look. And it'll really shimmer as well once it's dry because of the mica. Just turning it round as I work my way round the butterflies. Before I use the next colour on the butterflies, which is the dragonfly, I'm going to heat set this with my heat gun so that the colours don't contaminate each other and give me a muddy pool. But you can still see the pattern through the peach that I've used. Yeah, so that's all done. I just pick up the excess and just add it hither and thither around the butterflies. So that's that done. Clean my brush, wipe that up, and I'll just give it a quick blast with the heat gun. So as you can you see, I'll just move the camera down a bit so you can see. There we are. See the shimmer. And again, the same with the dragonfly. Just give it a shake and spritz some on my works mat. Clean my lid. Go in with the dragonfly. And paint the butterflies. Very therapeutic, really nice to paint with as well, the spritzing. I always like to think of other ways of using my sprays. And I want to use this on the outside, so I'm going to quickly just colour. Again, I'm just going to colour the wings in on this one. Don't want to colour the body. Just the wings of the butterfly. I do love butterflies. That's nice and quick and simple, quick and easy to do. And again, just do the antennas. I'm hoping to be able to cut the antenna out, but we'll see. We'll see. So, give him thick antennas. Here they are. So that'll excuse me, that'll be cut out later. Okay, wipe up my mess. And now the fun start begins. Okay, I have had a quick practice play with this. But I thought what we could do today is I would go through step by step with you. And we'll take it. So it's saying for step one. Now I'll just go through the what you get with this in this series. You get Boardwalk, which is a glimmer mist. You get chalkboard, a cardboard, which is a brownie. Then you get ivory and you get mercury glass. And it says for step one to pour a small amount of mercury glass onto a non-stick surface, scrunch up a clean paper towel, pick up some mercury glass, lightly dab in long sweeping motions across your project, creating a smooth wood grain, a soft wood grain. Apply with light pressure to the paper towel. Make sure you leave open spaces. Apply in a random fashion. So as it says with all of them, give them a shake from side to side. So a clean paper towel. And I'll just put a little bit on my work surface. In fact, I won't. Just bear with me, I'll get a palette. I'll get a palette, that's better. I just pour a little bit. And I've poured that much in because this is, I want to do all sides of this. So in long sweeping motions now, and leaving some not doing it, covering it all, I'm leaving some spaces. Now I'll do these sides. I just thought it would be fun for us to go through it together because I've only ever done this on paper and I just wanted to see what it looks like on wood. We could I'll show you. You know, so if I make mistakes, which we all do, excuse me. I hope I'm not coming down with anything. I've got a tickle in my throat. So there we are. Darker in places. So can you see? All around. So that's that done. And the reason I've used this is I can pour this back into my bottle. Okay, so so I'm just going to give that a quick blast. For the next step, I need a small brush, so I'm going to use my number 6, and follow the grain lines you just created, making a darker wood grain with the mercury glass. You could add fine knots, so we can go again back in with this and just make knots. All around the side as well. Oops. Sorry about that. I think that's it, the last side. Okay, my brush. And then it says, while step 3, while the mercury glass is still wet, add 3 full sprays of boardwalk, leaving some areas open with no paint to help create a more natural wood effect. So that is the boardwalk. I'll give that a quick shake. Just pop that in the middle there. Just forgot the insides. If you just bear with me a minute, I'll just let my posse cat in. She's in. So three full bursts. Right, okay. So as you can see, I hope you can see, and it's gone everywhere. So I'm going to let that dry with the heat gun. Next step is to apply a heavy coat using the ivory. Apply a heavy coat over the entire project. I'll bring this in. I'll dry that. Then I'll move round the sides. I'm letting it pool as well. Doesn't want to play this. There they are. So can you see now with the ivory where it's pooled and I've just left it to dry? This is a mess of business. Excuse me. I need a baby wipe. Okay, so now what I've got to do is with the cardboard, which is this colour, just like a brownie colour, I've got to apply spray in two separate areas. So I think I'll do it in two corners. And then just spray it around the side very gently. I'm really pleased with how that looks. Looks quite good, doesn't it? You can add more, but I'm quite happy with that. And now you can see why I added the low tack tape to the glass. So what I want to do next is I want to I've got some of this bronze glimmer mist. Oh, just what I want to do, I want a piece of sponge. And I'm just going to take some of it onto the thing and I'm just going to do the edges. Round the frame. And another thing I want to do with the bronze is just spritz this weird and it heat set it. So that's got a nice and that'll sit up there like that. So all that's left for me to do now is I want to stick this to here. And for that I'm going to be using the golden gel medium. And just spread it across like I'm buttering a piece of bread. And that this will help stick my butterflies. My butterflies to the inside of the frame.
There we are.
So I want to peel this off, give it a quick wipe. Yeah. I will, as always, do still photographs at the end for you to see. And I've got a little pussycat sat by the side of me watching what I do, which is quite amusing. Just a simple PVA glue in this, and I'll just add some glue here to stick my Explore. Since I lost Tiggy, my eldest cat, my youngest cat Fluffy's been very clingy, so she follows me around everywhere. Don't you? Hey? Just going to put Explore there. Cut out this butterfly. It'll take me 2 minutes. I will cut to the end so you don't have to sit and watch me cut out a butterfly, because I think you might be a bit I think we can all cut out, so I will see you at the end when it's all cut out. So my butterflies all cut out now, and because of the white edges I like to go round them, and I'm using a distress marker by Tim Holtz called Cracked Pistachio, and I'll just quickly run round all the edges. I just think it brings it all together then. I don't like white edges at all, especially on things that I've cut out. Doesn't matter if the core of the card is not white or it's the colour that you're playing with, so it just looks better than the white. And then I can shape my butterfly with my fingers, and I think we'll have it going in like that, so it's homing in. And that is a quick and easy project, but I really just wanted you to see how to use the the paint system, the fine wood. And every time you use it, it will be different. And I think the more times you use it, the system, the better you'll be. But on the whole, I'm really pleased with how this has turned out, and I hope you've enjoyed my little project today. I am a big butterfly fan, so when I saw the butterflies I knew exactly what I wanted to do. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you do enjoy, and if you do treat yourself to the Tattered Angels paint system for fine wood, then please share with us on the Canvas Core Brand Facebook page. And until next time, happy crafting. Bye bye.